as you know, skiing is done on snow, and snow is, weather has to be cold. Typically, the mountains, it's very, very cold. You're skiing in Colorado, it's zero or below. And my partner Sharon also is a skier, and she gets very cold. So she is the electronic skier. She has heated ski gloves, heated ski boots, and you come into the lodge at night and there's an array of batteries plugged into the chargers all over the, every outlet in the wall, charging plugged into charging the batteries. So it occurred to me that wouldn't it be nice if we could develop an integrated system where boots, gloves, and eventually the suit itself can be fueled by a battery pack. Not just heated, but the battery would be smart enough to monitor the temperature. So you wouldn't get too much heat if you didn't want it, and if the heat conditions change, the heating level changes. So our team did that, and I wanted to acknowledge Sturgeon Ski Shop, which donated boots and gloves and ski suit to us. Pack up and put all kinds of things in. And a team did that, and they never implemented one really important part of it, and that is to monitor how much battery life is left. So a skier would potentially would be out there skiing downhill and suddenly get very, very cold, very cold. So Charles was given the task of a project that also added the capability of monitoring how much battery energy is left, so someone could judge how much time they have left before they have to replace the battery. That's where we're at. Charles,
thank you, Dr. Bricker. Hi, everyone. It's Nicholas for taking time to consider our presentation. I'm Charles, and I'm going to present my project, my very large IC, mini ski suit. So the presentation is going to break into the review of previous team, production, approach, hardware and software design, result, reflection, and analysis. I have the pair of resistor serve as voltage divided for the voltage going to the chip. And then there's a 5-volt regulator based all around the chip. And as I mentioned, they also use a coolant company as a secondary to calibrate the battery level. It's a sensor resistor with 50 mΩs. And for the pair of resistor, I use a 5-to-2 ratio. So the battery monitor IC reads single cell voltage from the battery pack. Well, in order to calibrate with the system design of the previous team, we're going to bypass the voltage divider circuit and then build a mini PCB that can be mounted above the original PCB and facing the response of the box. So this is the actual battery monitor IC, and this is the 5-volt regulator. And they are both actually 3x3 millimeter. As you can see, it's as thin as a scale. It's very, very, very tiny. And for the battery monitor IC, the lids are under the chip. So it makes it extremely difficult to solder it. And both of them are only available in service mode. And this is my PCB design. So initially I made a mistake on the pull-out voltage. I put it up to 3.7 volt, which is the voltage of a single battery cell. And I was able to fix that after I received my PCB board. And this is the PCB, the assembly circuit. The orange wire is used to fix the pull-out voltage. And as you can see, this is the battery monitor IC. So the problem with solder is super strong. First of all, since the battery monitor IC, the pins, the leads are under the chips, so we cannot use the soldering iron to solder the soldering stuff. You have to use the temperature control hot air gun. First, you gotta apply the solder to the applied box to the pad, and then you can solder the pads, and then you gotta hold your chips on the pad, and then you put the hot air to the chip so the solder will be melted. And since the chip is so small, I wasn't able to check if the solder joint is good. I tried to use a microscope, but it does not improve electrical contact. And by applying hot air to the chip, it is possible to damage the chip by overheating it. Okay, and the chip's using I2C as a data bus to read and write data from the chip. I followed the following procedure to read the data from the chip. And this is my code. First, you identify the chip address, then you start the transmission, read and write to the specific register, and then request data when it's available. So the results state, I made three PCB boards. Only one of them seems to be functional, the other two are not. Like one of them has a bad regulator, the other one has an unknown problem. And the signal from Arduino seems to be going to the battery monitor chip, but the chip does not respond correctly. I was able to prove this hardware problem or software problem. The data line returns 3 volts, while it's supposed to be at 0 or 5, indicates low and high. So still some limitation for the future work. For example, I would remove the battery monitor IC from the PCB, and then you use an oscilloscope to check the data sent to the chips, to the pad they connect to the chips. And then I would have my circuit sorted by a professional company. Even with the temperature hot air gun, you don't actually control the temperature applied to the chip, So it's still possible to manage the chip with a different algorithm. Afterward, you can test your software. So online YouTube classes, this class is project-oriented, open-ended, and close to real world. I've learned something that when in the class, I learned some application, for example, I2C, and use the data sheet of the specific device that you can use. And here's some bodies for the future team. For example, with the equipment that we have in the lab, I will always avoid surface mount, even though it's getting more and more popular. And contact the application engineer whenever you have a problem. They know the product very well. And I want to thank Upgrade for having this project, and Matikuruma for helping me design the circuit, and also the application engineer from Max Integrated. They made a chip for me, and PDTing the user ID permission as my part delivered to me as soon as possible. Thanks everyone.
Surface mount part that he was describing, we have to see the lead. So relevant to Kenny, but these parts really can only be attached using some fairly specialized equipment. What he was saying was he made a valiant effort with a hot air gun, but we're pretty sure that either the ship didn't connect or it's fried. However, I happened to see a YouTube video. I was investing research in this, and somebody turned a toaster oven into a temperature-controlled device for soldering these kind of parts on board. So, if any of you students want to do an independent study project, I will sponsor a conversion of a toaster to an integrated circuit production facility. The other thing I want to say is I was remiss in not introducing to you our faculty advisors who are here. Nicole Hamilton was the faculty advisor for the first team in Battery. Wayne Kimura is Charles's faculty advisor, and Eric Sotomayor, their faculty advisor for the 13th. Thank you very much for your efforts. So again, thank you.